set a ruler over every people.
That's why each nation, right, they have their own ruler. The Chinese have their own ruler. Who is that? Kim, what's his name?
Kim Jong-un,
or whatever his name is. He's the rule over, what's that, North Korea?
Yeah.
That's Korean? Okay. Okay, so he's over the Koreans then. But the Chinese have their own ruler, the Japanese, the Africans, they all have their own ruler, okay? So it says in division of the nations of the whole earth, the Most High has a ruler over every people, go ahead.
But Israel is the Lord's portion.
Did y'all hear that? Who's the Lord's portion?
But Israel is the Most High's portion.
So the Most High's portion of all the nations that he created on this earth is Israel. Not because I say, not because we say so, because we're reading scriptures. So we're reading to you who the Most High said his people are.
And it does not say anything about everybody coming together as one and living in peace and heart. Give me 1 Thessalonians 5:3. See, that's church. That's what church, that's how church, that's the doctrine that church puts in the minds of people. That's how they teach people to believe that everybody's the same, everybody's equal, and we're going to all be together in peace and harmony. Okay? That's their Martin Luther King doctrine. Okay?
And Martin Luther King got it from the so-called white people, man.
Right.
What do you think we learned the Bible? When do you think black people learned the Bible? In slavery.
Right.
And what about the Bible was we learning?
The curriculum that was passed down to us by our slave masters, which was the so-called white race, okay?
Which was turn the other cheek, love your master.
Obey your master.
And then when you get in heaven, it's going to all be better for you. You're going to all have your piece of pie but in the sky, but after you did.
After you served the so-called white man in slavery on earth. See?
That's what they indoctrinated into us in slavery in the Christian church.
Right.
See? And that same slave doctrine is still alive today in the Christian church.
Oh, dang.
See? Read what you got.
The book of 1 Thessalonians chapter 5, verse 3. For when they shall say, peace and safety.
Ain't that what everybody's saying? You guys are preaching hate. You know?
Oh,
you guys are preaching hate. You don't, you have no love.
Right.
You know? So we're supposed to just hold hands with the whole boardwalk and just sing church songs, you know, about everything's gonna be glorious. We're gonna be
in peace and safety, right? But the Most High said, well, when they shall say peace and safety, read.
Then sudden destruction cometh upon them.
Right. Then sudden destruction is going to come upon them. You know why this sudden destruction is going to come upon them?
Give me Isaiah 13 and verse 11.
We're going to read to you why sudden destruction is going to. This is one of the reasons right here. Because it's been nothing but a bunch of lies being taught in this society. Being taught in America. Being taught through the Christian church. Aren't you taught in the Christian church that this is what the anointed Savior looks like? You're taught that he's a Caucasian? See, this is one of the reasons why the Most High is going to destroy this place. Because you've been teaching lies, man.
And our people need to get up out of this lie that Christ is white. Or you say, well, his color doesn't matter. If his color didn't matter, then the Most High wouldn't put it in the Bible.
Right.
That's right.
So who are you? Who is anybody to come behind the Most High after giving you his color, and then you're going to come behind that and say, well, that color that the Most High gave us doesn't matter. See? That's wicked as hell, man.
Right.
Read that, Isaiah 13 and verse 11. Go ahead.
The prophet Isaiah chapter 13 verse 11. And I will punish the world for their evil.
He's going to punish the world for their evil. Okay? Go ahead.
And the wicked for their iniquity.
And the wicked for their iniquity. So the Most High is going to visit this earth. He's going to punish the wicked for their evil. Right? And for their iniquity. You know, what are they? Because they teach you that homosexuality is okay. It's an alternative lifestyle. They pass laws and legislation allowing gay couples to be married, just like that lesbian Queen Latifah. Queen Latifah got on what was it, the BET Awards or one of them black award shows? Oh, that was the Grammys. And what did she do? Get up there and marry a whole slew of homosexuals, man.
Wow,
and it was illegal marriage too. See? So she's bought out. She's been bought off, man. She loves this world. See? But the Most High, when the Most High said he's gonna punish this world for their evil. See what I'm saying? Because that's an evil practice.
That's right.
Homosexuality is an abomination according to the Most High. It's in the scriptures. Lesbianism is an abomination. Give me Leviticus 18 and verse 18. They like to tell you that the laws were done away with. The laws of Moses were done away with. Okay, so let's go to one of the laws of Moses, and you can use your wisdom and understanding and determine whether or not this has been done away with. Read that.
The book of Leviticus 20:13.
Give me 18 and verse 18. Give me 18 and verse 18. Go ahead.
The book of Leviticus 18 and 18. Neither shalt thou take a wife to her sister.
No. That's 18. Somewhere in combat for a long period of time, and you might need to relieve yourself. What's going on, bro? All right. See, that's ridiculous, man. You're gonna make a wicked provision for the flesh, okay? So that you can relieve yourself in a car. That's wicked as hell, man.
Hey, do you mind if I ask you something?
Yeah, go ahead.
What are you talking about?
Well. What we're breaking down is the fact that the laws of the Most High, the laws of the Bible, even though they're in the Old Testament, that they were never done away with. And we just read a few of the laws, you know, that like the one about laying with two men laying down together, which is homosexuality, or a man laying with an animal.
All right.
Yeah, and the Bible says it's an abomination.
Abomination.
That means it's a filthy and wicked act. Most High hates them with a passion. Okay, but now here in America, they allow that. They just like I was saying, they passed a law where it's not illegal. That means it's legal for like the armed forces or the military, if they're somewhere in combat battle, they can lay with an animal. They can have sex with an animal. And we already know that they legalize homosexuality, right? So, just period. I mean, they already done legalized that. Certain states have that on the books right now, where where two men can marry or two women can marry. See what I'm saying? So that's
going against the Bible.
Yeah, that's going against the laws of the Most High. Yeah. He gave us law. So, but now this is the thing though. When you go to church, the church teaches that the laws of Moses were done away with. They say we're not under the laws. And they when they say not under the laws, they're talking about the laws of the Old Testament. So therefore, we're like the true Sabbath day. You know what the true Sabbath day is? The true Sabbath day is Friday sundown to Saturday sundown. Because the day begins when the sun goes down. It doesn't begin when the sun goes up. It begins when it goes down. Okay, so the true Sabbath day is the seventh day of the week. It's not Sunday. Sunday's the first day, you have the first day, and then you have the seventh day, which is the Sabbath day. So now what day do most people go to church? They go Sunday. So that means, yeah, well, I mean, I was raised the same way.
I was raised, so.
Yeah, I went to church on Sunday.
I thought I was going to church on Sunday.
Yeah. Yeah, see, but
I want
you to not. Yeah. You know, mom said, you going to church. She going to church today.
Get up, get dressed, go to church.
That's right. That's right.
That was that.
But see, you know what happened? Most High, give me John 6 and verse 44. Give me St. John 14 and 6 verse. Give me St. John 14 and verse 6. Because, you know, a lot of us was raised that way. Most of these brothers was raised in the Christian church. But the things we were learning, we weren't learning the truth in the Christian church. Okay? And that one day of
Christians want to put it as
yeah. See, Christians, they don't go according to the scripture. They go according to like
their
beliefs and whatever they feel. See what I'm saying? Because if they're gonna do away with the laws, if there's no laws, then most likely then everybody's gonna be doing what they wanna do. Like it's you're not supposed to sleep with another man's woman. That's adultery. So now, if the churches don't, and another thing with the churches do not do, they don't push the laws of the Most High. Yeah, they don't push the laws of the Most High. That's why the church members, they live according to sin, according to lies. Like the one like you just brought up, the true Sabbath day is not Sunday, it's Saturday, or the seventh day of the week, okay? Jesus Christ does not look like that, okay? He's a very dark-skinned man with woolly white hair. The apostles were not white people, okay? And then we're supposed to, what holidays? We're supposed to be keeping the high holy days of God.
Hey man, appreciate you stopping by.
That's right. All right. So let's read that. Give me 14 and verse 6.
The book of John, chapter 14, verse 6. Amashiach Yahushua saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the life. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
Christ is the way, which means he's the method. All right, brother. He's the method. He's the truth.
And the life.
And the life. That's right. We can't get to the Most High except we go through his son, the anointed Savior, Hamashiach Yahushua. Okay? We say his name in ancient Hebrew because they weren't calling him Jesus back in the first century. Alright? Well, one, they weren't speaking English, and two, there was the letter J in the English language. That's something recent. Right? When the King James authorized 47 scholars to translate the Bible into English, that was around 1611. Now, in 1611, there was no letter J in the English language. So, how can his name be Jesus? Okay? So it says, Christ says, read that again.
Hamashiach Yahushua saith unto him, I am the way, the truth, and the light. No man cometh unto the Father but by me.
Now, give me Matthew 7 and verse 21. Matthew 7 and verse 21. So what it, again? We're the Hebrew Israelites. We are here for the children of Israel to teach the Israelites, the people that are descended from Abraham, Isaac, and Jacob, which are so-called Negroes, Jamaicans, West Indians, Haitians, Dominicans, Panamanians, Puerto Ricans, Mexicans, Guatemala, Panama, Chile, Argentina, Native Americans. These people make up the 12 lost tribes. identity. We're calling ourselves by labels and terms that you don't find in the Bible. Okay? We're not an Asiatic black man, which it makes no sense at all to be an Asiatic and a black man. Okay? We are the true biblical Jews. Now let's give me what Christ said. Read that.
The disciple of Matthew, chapter 7, verse 21.
Go ahead.
Not everyone that saith unto me, Master, Master, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven.
Right.
Or Lord, Lord, not everyone that saith unto me, Lord, Lord, shall enter into the kingdom of heaven. Okay?
Go ahead.
But he that doeth the will of my Father, which is in heaven.
Right. But he that does the will of the Most High, which is in heaven. Well, what is the will of the Most High?
Right.
What is his will? Give me Psalms 40 and verse 8. Give me Colossians 1 and verse 9 first. Give me Colossians 1 and verse 9. Okay, because what is the will of the Father? See? We don't know what the will of the Father is. We certainly don't know it by way of the Christian church, man. We don't know the will of the Most High. Because his will is to keep his laws, statutes, and commandments, man. Now, how is the Christian church living according to the will of the Most High when they're being raised in the church by not keeping his laws, statutes, and commandments? See? And that's one thing we have to learn. We have to come out of that. Okay, because the laws of God were never, ever done away with. There's only one law I was done away with, and that was the sacrificial law. You got a question real quick, bro?
No.
Yeah. Hey, you know you're a Hebrew Israelite, right? You're a Jew. You're a Jew because it tells you that the Jews are black, and then it tells you that the Jews went into slavery on cargo slave ships. The slave trade of the 1600s is documented in the book of Deuteronomy. Okay? That's in the book of Deuteronomy. That's how we know that who the Jews are and who they are not. And we know that the true biblical Jews are not Caucasian people. Okay? How can the anointed Savior be a Jew? And the scripture tells you that he's dark-skinned with woolly hair. So how can Caucasian people be Jews? That's like saying there's a Chinese person and an African person, and they're both the same race. You might as well say that, because that makes no sense either. So it's based on scriptures, man, in other words. All right, we don't deal with emotions. You know, we know how emotional our people get over the Bible. We deal with facts. The facts are the scriptures. We're justified in what we say. Thank you, bro. Thank you, appreciate it. We're justified in what we say because it's in the scripture. So you're not going to hear us say anything that we won't be able to go to the Bible and pull that scripture out.